Welcome to Programming with Professor Califf. Today I'd like to talk about arithmetic in Java. To some extent, arithmetic in Java is exactly like the arithmetic we learned in elementary school, but there are a few things that are different. Let's start by talking about what our Java arithmetic operators are. The first two are easy. Addition and subtraction look familiar and work exactly as you would expect them to. This asterisk is for multiplication, as it is in many programming languages, because an X would just be confusing, and early keyboards didn't have a dot like the one we use in algebra. The asterisk was deemed a good substitute. Like addition and subtraction, multiplication works exactly as you expect it to. For division, we use the slash. Now this is a familiar symbol. For floating point numbers, division will work as expected. But for integers, it will take us back to our very first experience with division, because it does whole number division only. When we first divided 5 by 2, we got the answer 2 with remainder 1. With integers, Java's answer for 5 divided by 2 is 2, just that whole number part. Whenever we divide two integers, we have to remember this. So 2 divided by 4 is 0. However, that only applies to integers. 2.0 divided by 4 is 0.5. Integer division will only apply if both operands are integers. If either is a floating point number, any integer involved will be converted to a floating point number and floating point division will apply. If we're dealing with numbers like 2 or 2.0, we can easily choose between integer or floating point division. But what if we have integer variables but want to do floating point division? For example, I might be trying to find an average of integer values. Even though the original numbers were integers, I often want to have more information than integer division will give me. If the average is between 2 and 3, I may not want to just know that it's at least 2 and less than 3. I may want to know whether it's closer to 2 or to 3. However, I can't just add a 0.0 to one of my operands because they're both variables. Note that the fact that average is a double will have no impact on the division operation because that's done well before we do the assignment. As long as the two operands when we do the division are integers, we're going to do integer division. The solution to this is casting, or more formally, typecasting. This doesn't really change the original value, but rather makes a copy of the value in the new type. Then that copy is what we use. The syntax is to put the type name in parentheses in front of the value to be typecast. So our average calculation then becomes average is assigned double total divided by count. The cast converts the value in total to a double, and then the division is floating point division, so the result is what we want. Our final arithmetic operator in Java is the modulus, or remainder operator. It meaningfully applies only to integer values, and it gives the remainder after the integer division. So the meaning has nothing at all to do with percents. So the symbol was chosen fairly arbitrarily. You just need to memorize this means mod or remainder in Java, not anything to do with percentage. It's usually read mod as in 5 mod 2, which is 1, since the remainder of 5 divided by 2 is 1. If you have a really strong math background, you may want to be aware that this operator isn't exactly the same as modulus, though for positive numbers, the modulus and the remainder are always the same. One of the most common uses of this operator is determining whether a number is odd or even, but we're going to see some other uses as well. Before I wrap up this video, I want to briefly talk about the precedence of operators, what order we do things in. This is generally the same as what you learned back in elementary school. We're always going to first work through our parentheses inside out. Then we'll apply any typecasting operations. Then we work through our multiplication, division, and mod operators from left to right. Finally, we work through addition and subtraction from left to right. Casting can be our greatest challenge with precedence in arithmetic. One common mistake is this one. The problem here is that we make num1 a double, but we still apply integer division to num2 and num3, getting 0, before the double gets involved. So the result is 2.0, not the desired 2.75. Now, one way people will try to fix this is to use parentheses, but the problem is we've really just said do the whole calculation, then convert it to a double here. That's going to convert to a double right before we assign it into the double, but all of the actual calculation, both the division and the addition, are done on integers. And so we end up with 2.0 again. The correct way to deal with this is to actually put the cast directly onto either num2 or num3. You could cast both, but you don't need to. As long as you cast one of them, it will all be good. So we can put it right before num2, or we can put it on num3. If we do that, then we'll get the floating point division we were looking for, and then we can add the two. That will all work correctly, and we end up with 2.75. One other mistake that people will sometimes make is they put that double onto the numerator, but then add parentheses. Now this puts us back in the same kind of situation we were in our first example, because we have forced, because of the parentheses, we have forced the division to happen before the cast. And so the division happens on the integers, and then we do the cast. So we'll end up with 2.0 once again. Thanks for watching. I hope you found this helpful. In the next video, I'll be talking briefly about using named constants in Java.